Hi everyone. Today we are discussing about the atomic structure lesson. This is very useful for the 6th tenth lesson. This is the basic lesson for the chemistry from 6th to 10th. First of all, in atomic structure, atom. In the what? Here two words are there: atom and structure. How like it will be? The atom will form. How like? The atom is formed according to John Dalton in the 18th century. Matter is made up of some tiny particles. Tiny means small. With the help of the particles, any matter will be formed. Matter is nothing but we can say either human body or any table or any substance, any food item. Anyone will be made up of some tiny particles only. The tiny particles is nothing but we can say atoms, according to John Dalton. He is a Greek famous scientist and a biologist also. Now, I am coming from the atoms. According to John Dalton, what he was told, any particles in the living but we can say atoms. Atoms are indivisible and invisible. Atoms are indivisible and invisible. Indivisible means vibhajimpa sankhyam kaadu. Next, invisible, chudaleni. These are the two properties which belongs to atom. Atom is nothing but we can say indivisible and invisible according to John Dalton. According to John Dalton. See, generally indivisible means a small tiny particle which we can't see with our naked eye. At that time, who are the chemists are there? They are invented the electronic microscope. Electronic micro, micro is small. I already told, what are the atoms are there? They are tiny particles, small particles, which are with the help of our naked eye. That's why, with the help of electronic microscope only, we can observe the tiny particles. That particles is nothing but we can say atoms. Say atom only. So, atom only a small particle. In that atom also, other subatomic particles are there. They are called, for these subatomic particles, I have given one formula. TEN, PEN. One formula. So, what are the subatomic particles are there? In this PEN formula, P for a proton, E for a electron, N for a neutron, for a neutron. These are the subatomic particles in an atom. This is our last year was given in 10th class, main examination for one mark question, very important. Proton, electron and neutron. These three are the subatomic particles of the atom. Next, proton, electron and neutron. What type of charges these subatomic particles we have? Generally, the atom will be spherical shape. The atom will be the spherical shape. According to John Dalton. So, what are the subatomic particles which are lying in the inside of the atom? Some particles will be, some subatomic particles will be outside of the atom. So, here three types of subatomic particles are there: proton, electron, neutron. So, the central part of the atom is called a nucleus. Atom is called a nucleus. Most of the space will be vacant only in the atom. Only nucleus only will occupy a smaller space. Remaining total part will be most of the vacant space only. Now, what about the proton, electrons, and the neutrons? And these protons, electrons, and neutrons are situated in which place? In the atom. What are the electrons are there? That electrons are revolving around the atom. How like a planet revolving around the sun? Planets will be how like revolve around the sun? That like only electrons also revolving around the atom. In particular, stationary orbits. The under name of stationary orbits are called energy levels. Or they are given some names for that energy levels. K, L, M, N. That like energy levels are given. Why we can say the under name of energy levels, we can say stationary orbits. Vaivitam stationary means the electrons will neither lose their energy nor gain their energy. Even though always it will be rotating around the atom, they won't lose their energy, they won't gain their energy. That's why these orbits are, or these energy levels are called stationary orbits. Next I am coming from the, what about the protons and the electrons? Electrons are revolving around the atom, this light. So what type of charge these subatomic particles will have? Protons. In protons, the first letter will be P. P for a positive. Protons will have positive sign. Electrons will have negative sign. Neutrons will have neither positive nor negative. Eight neutrons means it is a neutral charge. Understand? Next, protons are emitted by the Goldsmith. Electrons are emitted by the J.J. Thomson. Neutron was invented by James Chadwick in the year of 1935. He was invented. So, out of three subatomic particles, we can give the importance of proton. Why? Because this is a positive charge. Positive always we can do the more value. That's why we have to give the importance of the proton. The protons and the neutrons, both are called protons plus neutrons are called nucleons. Why we can say nucleons? So these protons and neutrons will be inside the nucleus because of the these two subatomic particles will be inside the nucleus. That's why these are called nucleons. Protons plus neutrons will be inside the nucleus. A combination of protons and neutrons are called nucleons. So conclusion, that means here the atom will have neutral charge. But what about the charge of the nucleus? Nucleus, what type of charge it have? Means, how like we can say, means, based upon the protons and the neutrons, we can say, nucleus will have what type of charge? I already told you. Proton have the positive charge, neutron have the negative charge. Suppose, any atom you can take, suppose, for example, I am taking oxygen. Why? Because any living organism will be what must answer the layer oxygen only. That's why, for example, I am taking oxygen as an example.